So this lesson we're going to talk about the Unix find command. So find does just what it sounds like it does. It recursively examines a directory to find some criterion that matches what that you specify, and then you can take an action in the file, including just printing it to the screen, but you can also do more complicated things. So find in and of itself can be used to almost be a program, because essentially you're going to find some files and then take action on those files. And you can do this all from the command line. And it can be a little finicky, but basically you want to break up the find command into three groups. So of course the command itself, the next thing will be a list of paths so that you want to search, then a selection criterion. So in this case, we're just looking for a file named index.html, and then we're going to print it to the screen. And on Linux machines, print is the default command, so you actually don't have to specify it. And probably in most installation of find, print will be the default command. So here's a whole list of selection criteria, and it gives you an idea of what it does. You can select files based on their type, the user, the group, the name. The iName is an important one because of the Unix is case sensitive. So if you use iName, you can find a file in an insensitive case way. So let's look at a couple examples. First thing we could do is say search for files. So we're going to say find all files in the home directory that have the permissions, well, let's say of type D for directory, that have the permission 777, and then we'll print those to the screen. So you can see that there are two files. These are files I created called shared, and one's uppercase and lowercase, and I changed the permissions to 777. So they're the only two files in my home directory that have those permissions. So what then I could also do is, you know, be more specific. So of the files with permission 777, are there any named shared with a capital D, with a capital S rather? And we'll print those to the screen, of course. And then we could return to the original command by doing a case insensitive search, so iName, and that prints those. So in this case, in this example, we were only printing to the screen. However, there are other actions we can take, and we can, you know, do long listings of files. We can, the most useful is executing files, it looks like there's one called OK. I've never actually used it, but it says it's just like command, but then it's only executed after a user confirmation. So that could be useful, like if you wanted to use, for example, remove. That might be a good time to actually try this out. So we're here in the current directory. We have, you know, file 1, file 2, and file 3. Each with file extensions .dat and .txt. And so if we wanted to, say, do a long listing of the files in this directory that match the string file, right, what we could do is find in the current directory name, and we'll use a wildcard after file. So this will find all files named file, no matter their file extension, and then we can do a long listing on them, right? And so in this case, we found them. But what we might want to do is do a combination. So we might want to find all files named file, but with the file extension .txt. And so if we did that, we can combine this with name, file, and name. And then what we're going to do is negate. So we're going to use a negate operator. So we're going to say and not with the name dot dat. So that will find, say, all the text files. And there they are. Then we can actually feed those to a command, which we could use execute, right? And we could execute ls minus la on these files. And there that's been done. We could also do something like remove the files, and we'll want to do it interactively. So we're going to remove the files interactively so that it actually asks us before each one of these executes. And so it's saying yes, you know, do I want to remove the regular file? Yes. Remove this file? Yes. Remove that file? Yes, right? And so then we can see that the three files are gone. So if we want to, let's add them back. So now we have them there again. And we can run the file command again. It's just this time, instead of using the dash I, it looks like we can use OK. And this will run each command, again, asking us for a prompt. And that works also. So there's a couple of examples of how to use the find command. So we already looked at the some of the operators. We can negate commands. We can combine commands with and or operations. There's an example of how to use. You know, so this would find all files not named with a C file extension. This would find all files either named with a .sh or a .pl file extension and print them to the screen. And then there's the and, which we've already seen.